So here's the traffic light. When I first got it, it was extremely corroded. The aluminum is pitted everywhere. There was like powder inside of it just from the aluminum breaking down. It really looked like it was sitting in a swamp or something, partly underwater for a long time because some of the bottom inside areas had a little bit of green to it. So yeah, I mean, it was in rough shape. Here are just some more looks on the inside of the light. Again, as you can see, it's just really rough shape. The wiring was bad. Everything was just full of that aluminum powder from breaking down over time. Moving along here in the video, I'm just going to be showing you some more progress pictures, basically some before and afters. Like the later we get into video, the more progress will be done.
Here are the parts. Getting ready for sandblasting. I already got as much paint off as I can. And here are all these bolts. I'm gonna go ahead and replace them. I'm gonna replace all the bolts with some new ones and sandblast all that rust off the connectors for the pieces here. So you can see one bolt actually snapped. And over here on the rings for the lights, these pieces kind of worry me. They're really corroded. Hopefully they don't snap off or anything. I went ahead and cleaned all those connectors already. I got the rubber as clean as I can. It's still in really good shape, so nothing's dry rotted.
Here in this next part, I was just spray painting a few pieces. I put like three coats of primer. I started with silver, then some black primer, followed by a glossy black enamel, all of it rust prevention. Over here, you can see like I was working on the lights some more, polishing them up, making them look really nice. And then I also made a new cap for the bottom so it can go ahead and close the hole off on the bottom. And I also made new brackets to hold the lenses in place since the original ones all broke. Here's the traffic light controller I used, and I also went ahead and grounded each piece together and tested everything with a multimeter to make sure it's all solidly connected. Right here, I'm going to show you some close-ups of the inside of the light. We'll start with the wiring here. So you can see I made it very neat and organized. When I close this up, it's all looped here, comes underneath pretty nicely, and it just comes out the top here. On the back of the lights, you can also see all of the corrosion that was on it is completely gone. Everything is almost like brand new. The aluminum's a little pitted, but overall, I mean, it's in great shape. I ended up not putting the shades on it. I just think it looks a little bit better in the garage without the shades. You can see the lights from all angles then.